Following last year's outstanding 13-3 finish, the Washington Lee Generals graduated 8 seniors and expected to enter a rebuilding season for 2014-15. The club featured just 4 upperclassmen to go with 7 sophomores and 8 freshmen. Sophomore Carson Chirkop was handed the reins in net after showing promise during his freshman year when he served as the number 2 goalie for the club. Fellow sophomores Peter Harvey and Spencer Brown would anchor the blue line while the team relied on young and unproven players Vincent Schwinard, Jeffrey Henderson, Will Schmidt, and Connor McCormick to round out the defensive units. Senior captain Sandy Harvey and Ben Stanley, yet another sophomore, led a young but promising offense. First-year player Ned Huffman, John Petrich, Kayla Ehrlich, Theo Vargas, and Sarah Brown would find themselves thrust into action early and often, while Carlos Wilson, Francis Penny, Zach Ellison, Ewan Marsden, and Cole Praver provided some depth from a year ago. This is Neil Sika, and I am back with you to share a recap of the 2014-15 season for the Washington Lee Generals Hockey Club. The Generals opened the season with a non-league contest versus Potomac School. The Generals fell behind early before Ben Stanley evened the game late in the first period. In the second period, WL's power play went to work, leading to goals by Sandy Harvey and John Petrich. The Generals tallied 3 more times in the period to build a comfortable lead, and in the third, Harvey capped off the hat trick. In their first high school hockey game, several freshmen aided in the team's scoring, goals by Petrich and Ned Huffman, and assists from Theo Vargas and Kayla Ehrlich as the Generals cruised to a 7-3 win. In the inaugural game of the new Capital Scholastic Hockey League, Washington Lee hosted the Robinson Rams. The Generals again fell behind early, but tallies by Sandy Harvey, Spencer Brown, and 2 from Ben Stanley helped the Generals build a 4-1 lead. In the third period, the Rams rallied to bring the game within 1 goal, but stout defense and solid goaltending by Chirkop allowed the Generals to survive a thrilling finish. The first road test for the young club came when the Generals traveled to Prince William to face off against a talented Forest Park Hilton team. Carson Chirkop turned away a barrage of shots early, and Sandy Harvey scored on a breakaway midway through the first period to give the Generals a 1-0 lead. However, Forest Park Hilton's deeper and more experienced roster eventually wore down WL. 2 goals by Hilton in the second period and 2 more in the third gave Forest Park Hilton a decisive victory. Next up in the CSHL was the big and physical W.T. Woodson Cavaliers. WL scored first on a goal by Ben Stanley, and the teams traded goals to enter the final period tied at 2. Strong defense by Spencer Brown, Peter Harvey, Vincent Schwinard, Jeffrey Henderson, and Connor McCormick, along with excellent goaltending by Chirkop, held Woodson scoreless in the third period. With 6 minutes left in the game, Stanley completed the hat trick, and WL held on for the win. Final score, WL 3, Woodson 2, led by Stanley's hat trick. The Generals traveled back to Prince William for a showdown with undefeated Hayfield T.C. Lee. Despite being outshot 26-19, WL pulled off a stunning 5-1 victory. Francis Penny and Theo Vargas each tallied their first goal of the season, and Ben Stanley recorded his second hat trick in as many games. Chirkop was stellar once again, turning away all but 1 shot as the Generals improved their overall record to 4-1. Unfortunately, the following week, the Generals followed up their big win with a setback against a hungry West Potomac club. WL started flat, mustering just 3 shots in the first period, while the Wolverines tallied twice. The 2-0 lead held into the third until Ben Stanley scored a shorthanded goal with a little over 7 minutes to play. WL's play picked up over the final minutes, but it was too little, too late. 2 empty net goals sealed the win for West Potomac, handing WL their second loss of the season. Following winter break, the Generals returned to action for their second meeting against Forest Park Hilton. Ignited by a relentless forechecking effort and strong play from third line forwards Francis Penny, Sarah Brown, Zach Ellison, and Carlos Wilson, WL controlled the game from the onset. Sandy Harvey's natural hat trick and a couple of assists from freshman Jeffrey Henderson gave the Generals a 3-goal lead. The addition of senior defenseman Sukhman Nahal to the roster added more experience to the back line, which coupled with outstanding goaltending, stifling the opposition's attack as the Generals avenged their early season loss with a 3-1 stout victory. With the win, the Generals moved into second place in the CSHL. Next up was the Robinson Rams. The Generals entered their match allowing a league-low 2.5 goals against per game, while the Rams boasted the leading scorer in the CSHL. It was an inauspicious beginning to the game. Just 26 seconds in, the Rams scored to go up 1-0. The Generals tied the game midway through the first period, but gave up a goal late to fall back down. In the second period, the Generals' offense erupted, scoring four goals, three of which Spencer Brown assisted. WL would not relinquish the lead and closed the game out strong. Sandy Harvey finished with four goals, Spencer Brown with four assists, and goals by Petrich, Stanley, and Vargas rounded out the scoring as the Generals beat the Rams 7-4. Washington Lee and W.T. Woodson met for the second time, and the result was the same as the first, a 3-2 win for the Generals. Sandy Harvey and Ben Stanley tallied early to give the Generals a 2-0 lead. However, Woodson wouldn't go away, as the Cavaliers scored late in the first period to cut the gap in half. In the second period, freshman Vincent Chouinard scored on a shot from a point, giving the Generals all the insurance they would need. Chirkop was a rock in net yet again, stopping over 30 shots as the Generals improved to 7-2. The win over Woodson moved the Generals into first place and set up a huge showdown with number 2 Hayfield T.C. Lee, with the winner having the inside track to the number 1 seed in the playoffs. From the drop of the puck, the two teams battled toe-to-toe. Hayfield broke the ice first and eventually worked their way up to a 2-0 lead. Harvey and Stanley each scored to tie the game, but Hayfield countered twice in less than a minute to regain their two-goal advantage. Going into the third, the Generals fought back, and Ned Huffman's beautiful deflection brought the club to within one goal. WL had several opportunities to tie the game, including a power play in the final minutes, but it was not to be. Hayfield held on to win, defeating the Generals 4-3. In the final game of the CSHL regular season, Washington Lee traveled to Mount Vernon to face off against West Potomac in front of a home raucous crowd. The Wolverines fed off the energy of their fans and came out fast, scoring three goals in the first 7 minutes of action. WL was stunned, but regrouped and eventually found themselves back in the game with a 5-on-3 power play. Sandy Harvey and Spencer Brown scored to regain some momentum. And in the final minute of the period, Ben Stanley tallied the equalizer. The Wild 6-goal first period was followed by another 5 goals between the two teams in the second. Sandy Harvey scored all three of WL's goals to give the Generals a 1-goal lead going into the final stanza. The Generals battled right to the end, but were unable to find the back of the net in the third period, while the Wolverines scored 3 times and added an empty net goal to close out this wild back-and-forth affair. Sandy Harvey finished the game with 4 goals, bringing his total for the season up to 18 and breaking the club record of 17 goals in a season set by Chris Leo during the 2012-13 campaign. Despite losing the final 2 games of the season, the Generals earned the number 2 seed in the playoffs. WL looked to get back to their winning ways in their first-round match against number 5 Robinson, a team the Generals had beaten twice during the regular season. The young club started sluggish while the older and more experienced Rams came out fast. Carson Chirkop did his part to keep his team in the game, but the Rams eventually built a 3-goal lead by the third period. Sandy Harvey eventually got the Generals on the board and gave the team some hope. Robinson scored again, but on the following faceoff, Spencer Brown jumped the draw, stealing the puck, and splitting the Rams' defense to get a shot on net. The Rams' goalie made the save, but during the ensuing scramble for the rebound, Francis Penny banged in the goal to cut the lead back to 2. Robinson's defensive strategy clamped down on WL's attack in the final minutes, and the Generals eventually ran out of time. Upset by 2 goals, the Generals were eliminated from the playoffs. In the season finale, Washington Lee faced Yorktown. Both teams celebrated their seniors with pregame pomp and circumstance in front of a packed house before dropping the puck. Yorktown broke the ice with a goal a few minutes into the game. WL evened the game later in the first period when John Petrich took a pass from Ben Stanley and buried the puck in the back of the net. But Yorktown countered with two goals before the period came to an end. The Generals settled things down in the second period, holding the Patriots scoreless. However, WL was not able to capitalize on their chances. As the game wore on, the more experienced and deeper Patriots grinded down the Generals. A goal by Yorktown late in the period ended any hope of an upset as Yorktown handed the Generals another loss to close out the year. At the beginning of the season, expectations were small for a club that had to rely heavily on so many underclassmen. However, despite their youth and inexperience, this team overachieved, highlighted by finishing number 2 in the CSHL's regular season. While this accomplishment is something this team should be proud of, the Generals also learned a tough lesson when they failed to play their best hockey in the playoffs. 16 players will return next year with the opportunity to build on that experience. For Zach Ellison, Ewan Marsden, Sukhman Nahal, and Sandy Harvey, their high school hockey careers have come to a close. They can depart knowing that they've helped guide the club to its third straight winning season and fourth in 5 years, adding another layer of excellence to the foundation built by those who came through the program before them. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the 2014-15 Washington Lee Generals Hockey Club.